Let's see the third method, peptization method. Peptization method. Previously, we have discussed two methods, chemical methods and the second one, Bredig's arc method. In chemical methods, by a chemical reaction, colloidal solution is prepared. In the Bredig's arc method, metal salts, generally gold salt, copper salt, silver salt are prepared in Bredig's arc method. We have discussed those methods. Now, peptization method, what is this? Peptization is a process which converts a precipitate into particles in colloidal range. Precipitate means it's a suspension. You know, suspension is having a relatively larger size than colloidal particles. I had earlier explained that three types of mixtures, binary mixtures, true solution, colloidal solution, suspension. These three binary mixtures vary in particle sizes. What are particle sizes in these three mixtures? In true solution, the particle size is less than 10 power minus 9 meters in true solution. Whereas in colloidal solution, the particle range is 10 power minus 9 to 10 power minus 6 meters. Whereas in suspension, it is greater than 10 power minus 6 meters. So, these are the three binary mixtures. What is the first one? It is a true solution. Earlier I had explained already. It is colloidal solution. It is in suspension. So, particles of diffused phase have this range in size. In colloidal solution, particles have this range. In suspension, this range. Now, we are preparing colloidal solutions from suspension to this colloidal solution. So, what to do? So, we have to decrease the size of the particles. So, from suspension to colloidal solution involves breaking off larger particles into smaller. So, for that we use one important method, that is peptization. So, what is peptization method? It is the process of converting a precipitate, PPT means precipitate, into particles of colloidal range, that means into colloidal particles. By shaking it with a dispersion medium in the presence of a small amount of electrolyte. What is electrolyte? Any substance which can give ions in water or any in a polar solvent is said to be electrolyte. Sodium chloride is an electrolyte, FeCl3 is an electrolyte, AlCl3 is an electrolyte. So, in that way. So, you know, for the stability of colloidal solution, electrolyte is also required in smaller amounts. A smaller requisite amount is required. Okay? So, conversion of a precipitate into colloidal solution is called peptization. See, an example for peptization method. Ferric hydroxide, which is a precipitate, ferric hydroxide, freshly prepared precipitate, PPT. So, when it is kept in water in the presence of some FeCl3, what happens? Its FeO is taken, salt will be prepared. This side, ferric hydroxide is a precipitate, that is in water. But this side, ferric hydroxide, colloidal solution is prepared. So, what is the difference between salt and precipitate? Here, particle size is more. I said it earlier. in the suspension particle size ranges greater than 10 power minus 6 meters, whereas in colloidal solution, colloidal particle range is 10 power minus 9 to 10 power minus 6. So, size of particle is decreased by this solvent and this electrolyte. Here, this water is the dispersion medium DM, dispersion medium DM. This FeCl3 is electrolyte added. I said earlier that electrolyte is must, but in smaller amounts, it stabilizes the colloidal solution. So, finally, what is peptidization? The conversion of a precipitate, the conversion of a precipitate into colloidal solution by shaking it with a dispersion medium in the presence of a small amount of electrolyte. Here, what is the role of electrolyte? Here, what happens is when electrolyte, this precipitate is shaken with the dispersion medium in the presence of electrolyte, this precipitate adsorbs, this precipitate adsorbs the electrolyte particles on its surface. These are electrolyte ions. Those ions are adsorbed on the surface of precipitate. These adsorbed electrolyte molecules now break down the precipitate into smaller pieces which are in the colloidal range. In that way, the bulkier precipitate now split up into small pieces in the colloidal range. So, that is the method of preparation of colloidal solution using this peptidization method.